But y'all did the preliminary, so I know y'all know your material and everything. So I am not nervous. I'm very comfortable. I know that y'all are going to star. All right? And we're going to televise it. So that is not to make you any extra nervous. Think about the material. Focus on the person who is going to be asking you the questions. Answer them. And everything will run smooth. Because y'all did SEA this year, right? Let me see the hands of all those who did SEA. All right. Well, I mean, if y'all passed through SEA. And how y'all felt those of y'all who to the back to come and come forward a little bit? Just come forward. That's it. Yes, get a little closer. Yes. See, the team is coming downstairs now, so we can, as soon as they settle in, we'll get started. Everyone has a program, yes? Good. All right, I'm going to hand you...
Wow. At the Oilfield Workers Trade Union. What we want to do... It's just move folks up just a little bit so that when we end up on TV, we actually see your face. So if we can fill in the empty chairs up in front, I'll ask that everyone stand. And I'd like to ask one of the chief cooks and bottle washers of this event, Stacey Herbert, to lead us in prayer.
Let's bow our heads. Father God, I give you praise and I thank you for this day. We thank you, O God, for bringing us together for this time. We pray, O God, that everything, O God, will go in according to your plan. God, we thank you for bringing us here again, and we pray that you will take control. In your name we pray. Amen.
Though this is not necessarily on the program, we acknowledge that there are two other major religions here. Would anyone like to come from the Muslim faith or the Hindu faith to offer prayer? No? All right. Okay. So just waiting for Kathy Smith from the OWTU Secretariat to sing the national anthem. But before we do that, I would just like to go ahead and acknowledge the members of staff who are here. So we have Stacey Herbert, as I said, one of the chief coordinators of this event. Ozzy Warwick, chief education and research officer. Denise Patterson, wave Denise, you're on camera. Denise Patterson, who is going to be at the board, our chief scorer. And two supporting scorers, we have Kalisa Remy and Candice Sebro. And our timekeeper, Derek Scotland, who'll be joining us shortly. Ah, there he is, Derek Scotland. Would obviously indicate when your time is up. So he's our timekeeper. Yes, that's Denise Patterson. All right, can I ask that Kathy Smith come and lead us in the national anthem, please?
Forged from the love of living. In the fires of hope and prayer, with boundless faith in our destiny, we solemnly declare, side by side we stand, islands of the blue Caribbean Sea, this our native land, we pledge our lives to thee, hear every creed. May God bless our nation. Hear every creed and race, find an equal place. And may God bless our nation.
Thank you very much, Kathy Smith. And I'd like to invite you to be seated now. And I know he's not a strange voice or a strange face, and so he may not want to go to the podium to seem too official, but the Chief Education and Research Officer of the OWTU would like to officially welcome you and give some remarks. So can we welcome Ozzy Warwick, the young, the vibrant, and questionable good-looking.
Thank you very much. Nikki Johnson, our Education and Research Officer of the OWTU, and who will be, of course, your MC slash moderator slash coordinator, etc., etc. Good morning. I know you sound a little nervous. This is the semifinals and finals of this really important quiz and poster competition. But I also know that you all are well prepared and you're very comfortable. So, good morning. All right, I say good morning because I think the airing will be in the morning. It's really an honor and a pleasure for me to welcome you all to this 38th annual quiz and poster competition of the Oilfield Workers Trade Union. So that is 38 years we've been doing this. And we have seen many young people, which means those who would have participated in this in the very first competition, are now members of our society contributing in the work in the world of work. And one of the things we've noticed about our quiz and poster competition is that many times, almost every year, one of in the top 10 SEA students tend to be students who have participated in our quiz and poster competition. So which means I will be looking out in the news for one of you all in the papers or on the television to see which one of you all would have come at least within the top 10 spaces in the SCA competition. So this year we wanted to focus on something very important, climate change. And that is a big topic because right even this year there was a big international conference on the environment, on climate. And living on a twin island republic, it is very important for us to be aware of the environment and to be aware of climate change. But more importantly, how can we help change the world? How we can make this planet our only home for now. What we know is that this is our only home. How we can ensure that we can live sustainably on this beautiful planet. And so we had the poster competition to depict that theme. And I really want us to give a round of applause for all those students who participated in the poster competition, whether they placed or not. Let us give them a round of applause. Because if you look at the posters to my right, your left, you would see some really beautiful depictions of the theme, Let Us Save Our Planet. And this is how, as young people, you saw how how you can help save our planet, how we can help save our planet. And they're really beautiful drawings. I enjoyed looking at them. And I think you would agree with me when I say that indeed young people are the future and in fact have the solutions for many of our problems. So let's give them again another round of applause, those who participated in the poster. This year we had some 31 schools participating in the preliminary round. 31 schools from the county of St. Patrick and Victoria. That took place on the 26th of May. Out of the 31, we came down to quarterfinals of some 16 schools, which took place on the 8th of June. That was the quarterfinal rounds, part one and part two. And coming out of that 16, we down to the big four, what we call the big four. Not to make you nervous. So you're the top four schools that came out of the competition this year. And I'd like to call out the schools because I think it's important that we identify the top four schools in this year's 38th annual OWTU Primary School quiz and poster competition. First, we have Avocat Vedic Primary School. Let's give them a round of applause. And let me just say, no stranger to this semi-finals and finals at all. Avocat is a regular, and so we let's see how we do today. Next, we are going from a school that has participated almost in every competition, making it all the way to the semifinals for sure. We now go to a school that is here for the very first time participating in this quiz and poster competition, and has made it to the semifinals, and that is Tulsa Trace Hindu. Let us give them a round of applause. And then we have another school that is no stranger to the semifinal rounds, and that is San Fernando Astra. Let us give San Fernando Astra a round of applause. And another school that is also no stranger to the semifinal rounds, and that is San Fernando TML. Let's give them a round of applause. Now, I know for a fact we're dealing here with champion schools. At least three of these schools, from one time or the other, some twice, three, four times, have become the overall champion. So today, not to put any pressure on Tulsa, but I am sure they are raring and ready to challenge the other big three. So I think we are going to have a very exciting semi-final rounds. I passed through the quarterfinals. I saw the passion in the students. So I know that they've been preparing from since then till now. But I think we should pay special recognition to their teachers who have this added responsibility in addition to SEA and so on, have really taken the time to work with you in preparing you. And I think it's sometimes we pass without really appreciating the value of the time that our teachers put in to ensure that you participate in these activities. So let us give a big round of applause to our teachers here with us today. And finally, of course, well, for one thing, none of us would be here without our parents, right? So, and of course, it's so important to have the support of our parents, because as much as your teacher may have wanted you to participate, your parents may have said, listen, you have enough things to do, enough activities you're involved in. You see this quiz and poster competition thing, give that a rest. But it didn't. They supported you all right through from preliminary rounds to quarterfinals to semifinals. And I know somebody, let's see the hands of all the parents who are here with us today. Oh, quite a bit. Let us give the parents a round of applause. To all the parents who are here and all the parents who could not make it, but here in spirit with you. So I don't want to take up too much more of your time, because I can see those faces saying, listen, why is he going on and on and on? Let's get this thing going. I'm ready to be crowned a champion. And no, I'm not going to do the champion dance. All right? As a matter of fact, I did contemplate coming out as Captain Planet. Do you all know Captain Planet? Let me see the hands of those who know Captain Planet. Too young to know? Well, when I was your age, I see the parents and teachers putting up their hands. When I was your age, there was a Captain Planet. But my staff said, Ozzy, please, you know, we don't think that that would be right. People will just spend more time laughing at you and not concentrating on the questions. The other character that has to do with environment and climate change is a local character, and that is Charlie. Anybody here remember Charlie? Well, I know that the Swim Call is going to relaunch Charlie. I'm excited about it. I'll tell you my own personal connection with Charlie. When I was your age, I participated in a national poster competition on Charlie. I'm not going to give away my age to say how many years ago that was, but I'm sure some of the parents and teachers remember Charlie. And I came third. I felt very proud of my poster of Charlie. And it was really sad because Charlie had a big impact on us as young people in terms of the importance of the environment. And I remember so effective was that campaign. We would tell our parents, make sure, do not litter, take off the lights, and so on. So I know that they're going to reintroduce Charlie. And so at some point, you are going to be introduced to Charlie. But today, for now, it's your day, your moment. So I will not take up any more of your time. I wish to thank you, welcome you to this 38th annual quiz and poster competition, the semi-final rounds. I really want to congratulate you all for making it this far, and I look forward to an exciting semi-final rounds. Please give yourselves once more a big round of applause. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Comrade Ozzy Warwick. Just a few housekeeping items. The restroom is to my right, which would be to your left. So to the front left is where the male and female restrooms are. And we'd like to invite persons to put their cell phones on vibrate or silent, please, before we begin. So what we'd like to do now is what we did for the quarterfinals is pick a number to see which of the semifinal rounds your school would be involved in. So there are two, right? So we have four schools. And I'd like to invite one representative from each of the semifinals to come forward. Caitlin is pushing somebody else, right? So just, Miss, Sir, could you just send up one representative to the front? And can I ask Shelley, Miss Shelley Anderson? So how this is going to work, right? The basket is right there. Go ahead. So Caitlin, that's Caitlin? Yes. So Caitlin, you start first, pick a number. Karen, Michael, and Nietzsche. Okay, so call out your number one at a time.
One.
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 Okay.
Two. Two.
Okay, so San Fernando Azure Primary goes up against Avocad Vedic. All right, can we give them a round of applause, please? And San Fernando TML goes up against Tulsa Trace Hindu. So, the students from these two schools who are on the panel, please proceed upstairs with your teacher. Can I ask that Caitlin and your two other colleagues, Miss, grab them and go upstairs, and Karen and your two other colleagues, Miss, Sir, yes, ladies, Miss, okay. All right, so one, you can have your seat now, and Michael. Okay, so let's get started. Gentlemen, I'm just cascading. Audience, forgive us, we have to do this miking process and audio and that kind of thing. So we have Richa, Brittany, and Anushka. Yeah.
Nice. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, we're about to begin. Mr. Mohammed, can I Get rid of this one? All right. Everyone's hearing me clearly? Okay. I think I'm as nervous as they are. I'm as nervous as they are right now. But I'm getting your energy. I'm getting your enthusiasm and your vibes. So, you know the drill. Before we begin, we need to read a few rules that apply. And it's important that we stick to the rules or else you can be disqualified. So, first up, there will be no talking. So when a question is asked of you, for example, I ask Anushka a question, Brittany can't whisper the answer to Anushka. That automatically disqualifies the school. Likewise, mom and dad, I feel your enthusiasm, but you or a teacher or a classmate cannot contribute as well. The only time that the team gets to share ideas and thoughts and answers is during a bonus point, all right? So no talking, no prompting. Each question asked of you or your team is 15 seconds. You have 15 seconds to answer that question. When you get an original question correct, you get 2 points. When you get a bonus question correct, you get 1 point. How a bonus question works, if I ask a team a question, a team member, and they're unable to answer the question, I pass the question to the opposite team. What we decided this year is that the entire school, all three, can huddle and actually come up with the answer. However, we encourage that one person gives the answer. I would like to encourage all of you to apply the wing it till you make it rule. That's to say, if you didn't get the answer correct in the first instance, you just keep trying. So I would say, sorry, incorrect, try again. And don't just be quiet and silent and slum. Actually, just keep trying. Good? You have 15 seconds. Maximize your 15 seconds. Are we okay with those rules? If there happens to be a draw or a tie, we have to break that with another round. And, of course, the theme this year didn't only focus on labor and OWTU's history, but climate change. So one round is dedicated to climate change. Are we ready to rumble? Yeah? Great. First question goes to San Fernando Azja. Richa. There are two calendar days of the year celebrated by workers and trade unions in Trinidad and Tobago. They are May Day and Labor Day. Tell me the month and the day that those two days are celebrated.
May Day is May the 5th and Labor Day is
So she had one part correct. Unfortunately for the semifinals and finals, we're not giving half marks. You have to give the full response. Therefore, that becomes a bonus question for the opposite team. Team, listen to the question. There are 2 days of the year that are very important to workers and trade unions. They are celebrated by workers and trade unions of Trinidad and Tobago. They are May Day and Labor Day. Tell me the month and the day that those two events are celebrated. Team?
May Day is May the 1st and Labor Day is June the 19th.
That's correct. So that's 1 point for Avocado Vida. Brittany, this is your question. May Day isn't only celebrated by workers in Trinidad and Tobago. It is recognized across the world. Can you give me the other name for May Day? That is correct. Anushka, where was the first official meeting of the OWTU held?
The first official meeting of the OWTU was in supporters of Mr. Williams in Coonstown Fight Back.
Well done. That is correct. This is your question. On June 19, 1937, there was a clash between protesting workers, demanding, of course, improvement for workers and their conditions, and a particular policeman in Faizabad. However, this policeman was killed. Can you tell me the name of the policeman?
Charlie
King. That is correct. And as a result of that, we now have Charlie King Junction. Amisha, this is your question. On June 19, 1937, workers in which oil field took strike action?
Workers in Apex.
That is correct. Apex Oil Fields. Michael, every trade union obviously has to be formally established. Can you tell me when was the OWTU formally established? Give me the day, the month, and the year.
June 1837.
All right, you have part of it. Try again. Okay. The question, therefore, goes as a bonus question to San Fernando Asja. That was incorrect, Michael. I'm sorry. The question again. When was the OWTU formally established? Give me the day, the month, and the year.
1937.
That is correct. June 25th, 1937. And that completes the first round. We move now to climate change questions. Richa, this is your first question. Over time, the number of hours in a day actually gets longer. Tell me, how much longer does a day get every 100 years?
0.017 seconds.
That is incorrect.
0.0017.
That is correct. 0.0017 seconds. It doesn't help us much, does it? We can't get much done in that time. But that is correct. 0.0017 seconds. Brittany, Pangaea wasn't the first supercontinent. What was the name of the supercontinent which existed 800 million years ago?
Rodinia.
Sorry?
Rodinia.
That is correct. Anushka, over millions of years, the supercontinents break up and they pull apart. And therefore, we are aware that there are several continents now existing. Name three of those continents that currently exist.
Asia, Antarctica, and Australia.
That is correct. Far too many of us think Africa is a country when in fact it's a continent, right? Now for Avocat Vidic. Leah, Earth's gravity isn't the same everywhere on Earth. What is the difference in gravity across Earth called? Guess out loud. Say it out loud. That's incorrect. Gravity across the Earth is entirely not... Okay. Sorry, that's incorrect. It becomes a bonus question. Then for San Fernando Asja. Listen to the question. Like, I know the answer, miss. Listen to the question. Earth's gravity actually isn't the same everywhere on Earth. What is the difference in gravity across Earth called?
Gravity anomalies.
That is correct. Gravity anomalies. I'm certain nobody in this room knew that, right? I didn't until I read the booklet. Now, this question goes to Amisha. Thank you. Sticking with the topic of gravity. Name the mission which maps the Earth's gravity. It has a cute little acronym, but I need both the acronym and the full name. Name the mission that is orbiting the Earth and it's mapping gravity. What is it called?
Mission
Anything that comes to mind. Okay. All right, that becomes a bonus question. Just for 1 point, but every count, every point matters. Team San Fernando Alge, the question again. Name the mission that is mapping the Earth's gravity. I need the acronym and the full name. That is correct. GRACE, that's the acronym, full name, Gravity Recovery and Climate Experiment. This question now for Michael. Carbon dioxide is a greenhouse gas. We all sort of know that, right? But name one other greenhouse gas. Just give me one.
Methane.
Methane, that is correct. So that's 2 points. We return now to our final round, focusing on labor and OWTU. Reach up, your question. The uprising, sometimes called the revolution of June 19th, 1937, obviously began June 19th, right? But when did it end?
June 2nd, 1937.
Say that again?
July 2nd, 1937.
That is correct. Brittany? By what other name was Chibol Uriah Buzz Butler called?
Chief Sivan.
Chief Sivan, that is correct. And Anushka? Who was the first General Secretary of the Oilfield Workers Trade Union?
Bush.
Incorrect. Try again. That becomes a bonus question for Abkhaz Bidik. Who was the first General Secretary of the Oilfield Workers Trade Union? Guess out loud. Try again. That is correct. She's like, I just guessed it out loud and it was correct. Yes. Hence, we encourage you to guess out loud. E.R. Blaze, who lived to 110. And he told us the history and story of workers from since 1937. That's quite fascinating. All right. So, last set of questions for Avocat Vide. Leah, you're on your feet now. Well, not literally. Adrian Kohler-Rienzi was also the first president general of which other union? Well done, that is correct. Amisha? The OWTU takes part in a Caribbean organization of progressive unions, parties, and entities known as the ACP. Tell me, what does the ACP stand for? Comes a bonus question for San Fernando Alge. The OWTU, this union, is also part of a Caribbean organization of progressive parties, unions, and organizations called the ACP. Can you tell me, what does ACP stand for?
Assembly of Caribbean People.
Well done, that is correct. The Assembly of Caribbean People, which actually meets every 2 years, is what ACP stands for. Michael, final question. From 1937 to present, the OWTU has had 5 president generals. Can you name them in order?
Adrian Colarienzi, John F.F. Rojas, George Weeks, Errol MacLeod, and Ansel Rogie.
Very well done. That is correct. Can we give them a round of applause? And we've concluded. I'm looking at my scorers tallying. All right, and we seem to have a score 12 by 18. So San Fernando Asja with 18 and Avocado Vidic with 12. Can we give them a round of applause, please? And so by virtue of the scores, though, I mean, they fought well. They really did. And I seem sort of like, gosh, I knew they knew that answer. Gosh. But that's all right. These are fighters, and we're all champions here. So automatically, San Fernando Asja, you are one of the finalists. So, can I ask that we congratulate them again as they exit the stage, so y'all can return to your seats. Oh, I'm so sorry. Mr. Mohammed, can you assist with the mics, please? Shreema, I got that right. Karen, great. Caitlin, Karina, Caitlin, Karina, and Ravita, good. We're just getting the order straight on the board as well. Right. Are we ready? Great. Tulsa Hindu, the first question goes to you. Samantha. 2 days of the year are celebrated by workers and trade unions in Trinidad and Tobago. They are very important calendar dates. They're May Day and Labor Day. Can you tell me the month and the day that these two events are celebrated every year?
May Day is celebrated on May the 1st, and Labor Day is celebrated on
indicated in the first round, we are not giving half marks for the semifinals and finals. You have to give the complete answer. Unfortunately, you did not complete the answer. Therefore, it becomes a bonus question for San Fernando TML. San Fernando TML, the question again. There are 2 days of the year that is celebrated by workers and trade unions in Trinidad and Tobago. These are important calendar dates. They are May Day and Labor Day. Tell me the month and the day that these two events are celebrated every year.
May Day is on May the 1st, and Labor Day is on the 9th of June.
That is correct. I'm feeling a little bit of nerves. I'd like us to just, I know you can edit this out after, but I want our students to be comfortable, right? So everybody just relax, breathe in, relax, right? Now, for Shreema. May Day is not only celebrated here in Trinidad and Tobago, it is actually recognized across the world. Can you give me the other name for May Day?
International Workers' Day.
That is correct. Question now for Kara. Where was the first official meeting of the OWTU held?
Long Track Hill Forest Reserve, Faizabad.
The first official meeting, not the secret meeting, the first official meeting. Try out loud. That becomes a bonus question for San Fernando TML. The question is, where was the first official meeting of the OWTU held? Out loud.
The quarters of one Mr. Williams, Coonstown Forest Reserve, Faizabad.
That is correct. And question now for Karen. No? Oh, I'm sorry. The questions now are for San Fernando TML. Caitlin,
On June 19, 1937, there was a clash between protesting workers, of course, who were clamoring for better working conditions for themselves and their families and community. But there was a clash between them and policemen. One policeman was killed. Can you give me his name?
Charlie Kitt.
That is correct. Karina, on June 19th, 1937, workers in which oil field took strike action?
Apex Oil Field, Faizabad.
That is correct. And Ravita, when was the OWTU formally established? Give me the month, the day, and the year.
On the 15th September 1937.
Incorrect. Try again.
25th of July 1937.
That is correct. This is the second round, therefore we're going to switch gears a little bit and focus on climate change. So Samantha, the first question is yours. Over time, the number of hours in a day actually gets longer. Tell me, how much longer does a day get every 100 years?
0.0017 seconds.
That is correct. 0.0017 seconds. Well done. Shreema, Pangaea wasn't the first supercontinent. Tell me, what was the name of the supercontinent which existed 800 million years ago?
Rodinia.
That is correct. Karen, last question is yours. Over millions of years, these supercontinents break apart, right? And therefore, you have several continents that currently exist. Can you name three of the continents that exist now?
North America, South America, and Australia.
That is correct. Caitlin? Earth's gravity isn't the same everywhere on Earth. What is the difference in gravity across Earth called?
Race?
That's incorrect. Try again.
Is it 0.3?
That's incorrect. Try again.
Theta?
Try again.
Anomalies?
I need the whole answer. Okay. Again, to reiterate, we are not giving half marks, so that becomes a bonus question, therefore. Sorry? Yes. And to reiterate again, all bonus questions, Shreema is asking, all bonus questions, you can come together as a team huddle to get the answer. Okay. So Earth's gravity isn't the same everywhere on Earth. What is the difference in gravity across Earth called?
They are called gravity anomalies.
Gravity anomalies, that is correct. Question now to Karina. Karina, sorry. Carbon dioxide is a greenhouse gas. We all are aware of that. There are others. Can you name one other greenhouse gas?
Nitrous oxide.
That is correct. Ravita? When Bertha Benz borrowed her husband's Benz patent motor wagon for her first long distance ride, she had to do everything. She basically was a mechanic, right? Including figuring out what gas to put in the car. Can you tell me what fuel or gas did Bertha Benz use?
Benzene.
Benzene, that is correct. Our two questions on labor and OWTU. Samantha, your question. The uprising which started on June 19, 1937, ended on what day?
June 19, 1937. That's when it started.
Say that again.
Is June 19, 1937 when it started? You could repeat the question.
Sure. The uprising which started on June 19, 1937 ended on what day?
July 2nd.
That is correct. July 2nd. I'm sorry, I didn't hear what you were saying. That is correct. Shreema, your question. By what name was Tubal Uriah Buzz Butler called?
Chief Servant.
Chief Servant, that is correct. Karen, your question. Who was the first General Secretary of the Oilfield Workers Trade Union?
McMoses.
Incorrect. Try again. Try out loud. All right, that becomes a bonus question for a San Fernando TML. Yes, I will repeat the question, Caitlin. Who was the first General Secretary of the Oilfield Workers Trade Union?
Blades.
That is correct. Question now for Caitlin while you are on your verbal feet. Adrian Cola Rienzi was also the first president general of which other union?
The Old Trinidad Sugar Estates and Factory Workers Trade Union.
That is correct. Karina, this is your question. The OWTU takes part in a Caribbean organization that brings together progressive parties, progressive unions, and other entities known as the ACP. Can you tell me what ACP stands for?
Assembly of Caribbean People.
Well done, that is correct. Ravita, this is yours. From 1937 to present, the OWTU has had 5 president generals. Can you name them all in order?
Adrian Cola Rienzi, John F.F. Rojas, George Weeks, Earl MacLeod, and Ansel Rogi.
That is correct. And that brings us to the end of this face-off. So we're waiting. So let's see. In the audience is like, sir, what is that face? He's like, oh gosh. Everybody's sort of nervous. I don't want your nervous nerves. Don't give me your nervous nerves. I don't want. How are we looking? Okay, so we have 2, so Trace with 13. Mr. Cameraman, unfortunately, transparency is not a character of yours. Okay, sorry. 19 for San Fernando TML, so 19. And 13, they put up a good fight, both teams. Can we give them a round of applause, please? You move on to the final round, which happens now. So let's take a short little break to have them sort of, Stacey, can I have some assistance, please? To have them transition. So again, can we congratulate both teams for a job well done? An effort put forward on both parts are worthy of congratulations. So can I ask Miss from Tulsa Trace Hindu School, to assist with the microphones? Let me know when it's... All right. Exactly the same as they were for the semifinals and the quarterfinals, which you had to endure. However, I will repeat them for your recollection. There will be no talking or prompting, and certainly I will not be prompting any of you. So when a question is asked of you, only you and you alone can answer that question. However, if your team is unable to answer that question, it goes to the other team and it becomes a bonus question. Every original question answered correctly is allotted 2 points. Every question that is answered as a bonus question, you are given 1 point. You have 15 seconds in which to answer any question, whether it's an original question asked of you or a bonus question. I encourage you to please, if I say incorrect or try again, do just that. Try again. Make use of your 15 seconds. Are we okay with those rules? All right. Our
our very own Vanna White at the board. Are we ready? Only the adults in the room would know what that means, right? Are we ready? Wheel of Fortune, yes, Ms. Caitlin.
Okay.
San Fernando, Asja. Richa, your first question. When non-oil workers were allowed to join the OWTU, the union was no longer described as a sectoral union, but now it became what type of union?
A regional.
A regional union is incorrect. Try again.
National.
Say it out loud.
National.
A national union. That is correct. Brittany. In 1967, British Petroleum threatened to retrench 1,500 workers. Shell also threatened to retrench 350 workers. In response, this union, the Oilfield Workers Trade Union, launched a campaign to save these jobs. What was the name of that historic campaign?
Not a Man Must Go.
Not a Man Must Go. That is correct. Anushka, this is your question. Originally, at annual conferences, in order to vote, it was a delegate system. However, there had to be a change in that process. What was the first time that elections were held when each member was entitled to vote?
The 25th of June, 1940-something.
Try again.
1939.
Try again.
1937.
Try again.
1962.
That is correct. So yes, when one member could have actually voted and not depend on a delegate system was in June 25th, 1962. So, Caitlin, this question is yours. The first industrial agreement signed by the OWTU in 1945 made history because it had a new allowance. What was the name of this allowance?
The cost of living allowance.
That is correct. So the cost of living allowance, folks, just as a side note, came into effect since 1945, courtesy the Oilfield Workers Trade Union. Karina. Name the local federation to which the Oilfield Workers Trade Union belongs.
Phaeton, Federation of Independent Trade Unions and NGOs.
That is correct. Phaeton, Federation of Independent Trade Unions and NGOs, which again, on a side note, is also very important and historic because it includes not just trade unions, but NGOs. Ravita, this is yours. Before becoming President General of the OWTU, Ansel Roger was President of which branch?
Point of Pay.
That's incorrect.
Point Fortin.
That's incorrect. Try again.
Port of Spain.
Try again. That then becomes a bonus question for San Fernando Asja. I'll repeat the question. Before becoming President General of the Oilfield Workers Trade Union, which branch was he president of?
Trinma.
That is correct, the Trinma branch. So we move now to round two. That's correct. We move now to round two and we focus on climate change. Richa, this is your question. CO2 is a big part of the carbon cycle. Name the terms used in the cycle to describe, one, parts of the cycle that add carbon, and two, parts of the cycle that remove carbon.
Parts that remove carbon are called sinks, and parts that add carbon are called sources.
Well done. That is correct. Brittany? What is the driest part on Earth?
The driest parts on Earth are located near the desert, the Atacama Desert.
Atacama Desert, that is correct. Anushka, the most important sinks are the oceans. That is to say, they absorb the majority of carbon dioxide in the air. Name one other major sink.
The plants?
Plants. That is one. That is correct. Caitlin? In 1860, it was discovered that carbon dioxide warmed the earth. Who first showed that carbon dioxide warmed the earth?
John Tyndall.
John Tyndall, that is correct. Name one, this is for Karina. Name one use for natural gas.
For heating homes.
That is correct, for heating homes. Ravita, petroleum wasn't always very popular until 1863, when something was invented, and this something is an internal combustion engine. Name the person who invented the internal combustion engine.
Nicholas Otto.
That is correct, Nicholas Otto. We return now to our final round. And as is customary, we will close off focusing on labor and OWTU's history. Richa, your question. In 1939, Butler formed his own union. What was the name of this union? Give me the whole name. That becomes a bonus question for San Fernando TML. In 1939, Butler formed his own union. What was the name of this union?
British Empire Workers, Peasants, and Ratepayers Union.
That is correct. British Empire Workers, Peasants, and Ratepayers Union. What is the name of the global federation? We don't only belong to a local federation, but we join arms in solidarity with workers across the world. Tell me, what is the name of the global federation to which the OWTU belongs?
The Industrial Global Union.
The Industrial Global Union, that is correct. Anushka. The bus strike of 1969 marked the start of what?
The Black Power disturbances.
The Black Power disturbances or the 1970 revolution. That is correct. Caitlin. Miss Patterson? Yes? In what year was Butler expelled from the OWTU?
1939.
That is correct. Karina, excuse me, at the 27th annual conference of delegates of the Oilfield Workers Trade Union, this is in 1967, non-oil workers were able to become members of the OWTU. However, they had to change a rule to make that happen.
Rule number two.
What rule? Yes, rule number two. Yes, Karina. Rule number two had to be changed in order for the OWTU to represent not just oil workers, but all workers from different sectors. And Ravita? Yes? Last question. The campaign to nationalize Texaco was known by what slogan?
Texaco must go.
Texaco must go. That is correct. Ty? I'm so sorry. I'm waiting for the tally, but one of my scorers is like, deadlock, deadlock. Wow, it makes life interesting. Take a 2-minute break, shake off. Let me confirm with the scorer. So the scorer on the board and my two scorers at the table have confirmed that San Fernando TML and San Fernando ASJA have both gained 17 points. Wow, congratulations to both of y'all. It means, however, yeah, don't look at me like, oh, miss, I'm exhausted. It means, however, that we have to break that tie with another round. So can I just ask that we take two to three. On the table is it simply a continuation from the first final, and we add the marks, or we erase the board and start afresh? So I'm asking our senior supervisor, who's been doing this for 30 something years, what was the precedent set when it did happen? All right? Any which way you take it, it's still zero because they are the same points, but you know. It's the same that the same thing. Okay. Does zero even go through? My point is 17 and 17 is 0 to 0, so it's, yeah. All right. Richa. When the unions... Let me get the green light from the audio and the videographers as well. Preacher, your question. When the union's rules were changed to allow non-oil workers to become members of the OWTU, which set of workers decided to join the union? Give me two.
The Trinidad Cement Limited and the
This becomes a bonus question for San Fernando TML. When the union's rules were changed to allow non-oil workers to join the union, Other members of other sectors chose to join. Can you name two of those sectors of workers?
Workers at the Trinidad Cement Limited and agricultural workers at Brighton.
That is correct. Brittany, this is your question. In the uprising, or often called the 1937 revolution, how many people were killed?
14 people were killed.
14 people were killed, that is correct. Anushka, this is your question. In what year did the chief servant die?
1977.
That is correct. Caitlin, your question. The OWTU negotiated its first industrial agreement in 1945 with a group representing several oil companies. What was the name of this group of oil companies?
The Oilfields Employers Association of Trinidad.
That is correct. The Oilfields Employers Association of Trinidad. Karina. Farmers decided to form a new union, the island-wide cane farmers union. Who became their leader?
Rafiq Shah.
Rafiq Shah, that is correct. Revita, this question is yours. President General Errol MacLeod negotiated the first profit-sharing arrangements in companies such as Petrotrin and National Petroleum. Name one other company in which profit-sharing arrangements were made.
Trinidad Cement Limited.
That is correct. Trinidad Cement Limited. Reach up. Oh. Waiting for our scorers to confirm. Yes? 24 to 21. Can we give both our schools, please, a round of applause? Just a mere 3 points. But as I said, every point counts. Ladies, and I'm so proud it's ladies. No offense to the men. But ladies, you did well. And all of the men just looked around at me with evil hawk eyes, like, wow. But ladies from San Fernando TML and San Fernando ASJA, you did well. Can you give yourselves a round of applause? And congratulations are in order for San Fernando TML, who are, yet again, I don't know if it's a hat trick. I think they need to come up with a new word in the dictionary to describe what this is. But this is another victory under the belt of San Fernando TML. So can we congratulate San Fernando TML, our official OWTU quiz winners? Thank you very much, ladies. Be sharing with us from memory dates and events, but the impact of activities. Bearing in mind, of course, the OWTU is not a passe institution. It is very relevant, very current, and still very, very important in contemporary life, even in young people's lives, right? So just to note, teachers in particular, the kinds of questions as of next year would also include why types of questions, right? Explain the impact, the significance, and those kinds of things. So again, congratulations to both teams, and we need to do a little shifferoo up in front to include persons who will be giving out prizes, to line up our prizes, to get rid of students, media workers. We have come to the official end of the 38th, and that was just a rehearsal. Yeah. Parents, students, media workers, members of staff at the Oilfield Workers Trade Union, we've officially come to the end of the 38th annual Labor Day primary school quiz and poster painting competition. Thank you very much for joining us here at the Paramount Building, OWTU's headquarters, for our prize-giving ceremony. We take pride every year in engaging young minds. We take pride every year in influencing and shaping young minds. Far too often, we're known for marches, being loud and rowdy, and those kinds of activities. Though important, we also engage every year religiously young students, demonstrated by the work on the board in areas of art and, of course, history. And key this year was the sub-theme, climate change, let's save our planet. After all, trade unionists are citizens of the world. So, to bring remarks on behalf of the Oilfield Workers Trade Union, we'd like to invite to the podium now our new General Secretary, Comrade Richard Lee. Can we welcome him, please?
Afternoon. Kids, teachers, supporters, members of the media, fellow executive colleagues, Comrade Dutton, the Education and Research Department, staff members, who made all this possible. And it was amazing for me yesterday seeing them set up those drawings there to realize that it was just 2 hours was the time allocated to put those things down. And I played my memory back a few years, not much years, but a few years ago, to when I was that age, 11 or 10, right? Not much ago, probably about a little over 20 years or so, right? And I'm sure that I would not have drawn so much things in 2 hours. That was amazing. So it really shows that the education that and the learnings that going to the development of youth and the young children now as the future going forward is so critical and important to challenge the mind and hopefully challenge the status quo for the kids. Going forward, you must always challenge. Once you believe what you believe, once it's right, and you believe it's right, to challenge status quo. Those there remind me when I was younger, right, to save the, let's save the earth, June the 5th, for you all will know, is World Environment Day. And to have that here on June the 15th, which is a couple of days after, is really a good thing. So I want to thank all the schools that participated And on behalf of the OWTU, the President General, the Executive, and all the members of the General Council, and by extension, the Annual Conference of Delegates, thank all the participants for coming to this this competition and entering and participating, and to see where we are now, down to the last group here. And I'm sure that what passed for the last 2 hours was actually really, really good, because I know I was hearing downstairs the interaction there. So I just want to say again, thank you all for participating. 38 years of this competition going. Yes, I'm the young General Secretary, but the history is at OWTU here. And we all here have been well-versed in the history, and we well know exactly what transpired through the years. So congratulations to you all. Give you all a round of applause, yourselves a round of applause, yes? And let's move forward, continue to learn. It's the most important thing that as a child you can get. Education is the most important tool moving forward in life. Thank you. Back to the MC, the chairman of the meeting. Okay.
Just kidding. All right. I'd like to acknowledge those at the head table. To my immediate right, we have Gregory Marchand, Vice President. Next to him, can we give him a round of applause, please? Next to him, we have the Assistant General Secretary, Jennifer Charles. And General Secretary Richard Lee. And this is a man who is very, very close to my heart, an adopted comrade, a real comrade in many ways too, because he was involved even before retirement in activism and such. He's an artist. This is one of the persons who would have judged the artwork, but the level of commitment he shows every single year, whether it rains, whether it dry, whether he's not necessarily in top shape health or in perfect health, he dedicates himself and his time and his artwork, and his skills, sorry. So can we put our hands together for Glenn Dotton? One of our other vice presidents, Sati Gajada Innes, to his right. And as you would notice, unlike some other unions, we do have a good gender mix at the executive level. To her right, though not an executive officer, she plays an executive role in the union, and a very important role, our accountant, Rauti Sinanan. Can we thank her as well? And all of the vouchers and monies that are being dispersed today would have come through her office, of course. So, we would like to begin this prize-giving ceremony. It involved 31 schools in different categories, poster painting, the quiz. But we want to start first with the poster painting winners. And I will begin with 12th place. Some of you might have had the opportunity to look at the board, take in some of the artwork. You can do that at the end as well. But however, those who didn't get a glimpse at the board, these are our top 12. And therefore, I would like to ask Gregory Marchand, to assist in the prize distribution. And we have as well Shelley Alexander. And I see Candace Sebrew, our new education and research officer, also assisting. I mean, it's really good to note the regeneration and the renewal, right? I mean, I have to mention it. The fact that there's so many young people on the stage. I'm not talking about those behind the head table, sorry. But they're younger people on the stage, and then they're young people behind the table. But definitely it's important for succession planning and renewal and regeneration in an organization as old as ours to begin to populate our offices or positions with young people, and therefore hand on the baton to others who will carry it for another 70 plus years. So first up, 12th place, we have Debe Hindu Primary, Leanna Sunnyboy. So can we congratulate Leanna Sunnyboy? Are you here? Please come forward. There you are. So come up stage, and Comrade Gregory Marchand will give you your certificate. Eleventh place, we have, and I mean, we want to show appreciation. We want to show a little love. You know what I mean? We want to be able to let our young people know that we see value in what they do, and they respond to this kind of love and appreciation. I have a one-year-old son, and I can tell you, they really go off on a clap. It's a big deal. So can we give them a clap when they're coming up? Sorry. When they're coming up. And we're getting a little technical and stage, right, some stage tips from Mr. Clifton there. So look forward when we're giving the prizes. That goes for all of our head table members. Aisha Blaze, where are you? Are you here? No? Okay, we will still mention you. 11th place, Aisha Blaze, San Fernando Girls Primary School. 10th place, Brian Tulsi. Brian Tulsi, are you here? Clark Road Hindu Primary School. Okay. Comrade Marchand, you can stay there. 9th place, we have Ariane Harry. There she is. Wow, she might be little, but she talawa. That's a phrase that I heard in Barbados, right? So judging by your artwork, you're a powerhouse with paints and crayons and paper. Eighth place, we have Janique Benjamin from San Fernando Girls Anglican Primary School. Are you here? And San Fernando, 7th place in the poster painting competition. We have, is it Cyan or Cyan? Cyan? Cyan. So we have Cyan Karim from San Fernando Azure Primary School, 7th place. Can you come forward? No? Okay. She's there? Oh, but perhaps the teacher can accept it on behalf of Cyan. Thank you very much, Comrade Marchand. I'd like to invite now one of our other vice presidents, Comrade Sati Gajida Innes, to distribute the 6th place to the 3rd place. Saeed Mohammed from Voss Government Primary School, 6th place. And in 5th place, we have Aaliyah Austin of Mount Pleasant Government Primary School. There she is. All right. You can do a little better than that. These are our children, all of them. Yes, he's saying sure. It's true. It really does take a village to raise children. Trust me, I know. 4th place, we have Kareem Ramadan. That's correct. Ramadan. Another little one, but definitely powerful. Kareem Ramadan, Santa Flora Government Primary. I love the Saga Boy walk there. He's like, yeah, this is all me. You better recognize. And we have from Pipara Presbyterian Primary School, 3rd place, Sharonda Ambrose. Are you with us? All right. So there's a little addition as we get to the top 3 in both categories. And I'd like, thank you very much. Could we thank our executive officer, Sati Gajida Innes, and our ever faithful young and young at heart, Mr. Dutton, Comrade Dutton, can you join us in the front so that we can distribute the 2nd and 1st place poster painting winners. In 2nd place, we have Ayari Welcome. And that's Faizabad Presbyterian Primary School. I absolutely love your last name. Welcome. Can we do a little better than that, please? Let folks around the corner on Coffee Street hear us. Winner, the first place winner, could probably even speak to the students and let them know what about that piece really won them first place. Sayan Maharaj from San Fernando TML Primary School. First place winner in this year's 38th Labor Day Primary School Poster Painting Competition hosted by the Oilfield Workers Trade Union. Turn the plaque forward, Mr. Dutton. Turn the plaque, that's right. Sayan Maharaj of San Fernando TML. Nice. What I'm going to summarize what he said. You said that she had a lot of vision. She poured out her vision on the paperwork, which a lot of older folks don't have, I think is what you added as a caveat. But yes, that is what it's about, pouring out your vision, pouring out your passion on paper. So those are our top 12 winners of this year's poster painting competition. Could we also congratulate the others who would have participated? Remember, it was 31 schools this year. And it's no easy feat to produce something in 2 hours. Granted, some students may have a group shot. All 12? Okay, so as I speak, can I ask that the top 12 return to the front, please? We have Guardian and Express who'd like to take a shot really quickly. They make, they can lead others, they can guide others, and by virtue of that, they are leaders of today. Without prize giving, I would like to acknowledge the winning school, the overall winning poster painting school, and this is a name and a school that we're very, very familiar with, San Fernando TML. So we'd like to invite the teachers, Miss, we big up all the girls, we big up the female executives, and Mrs. Like, no, I don't want to go up. There you go. A few more steps and you're at the front, voila. So we have our representative, Miss from San Fernando TML, the winning, overall winning school, San Fernando TML. We'd like to give you a trophy for the school. Oh, sorry, I meant to ask Comrade Lee to do that. I'm so sorry. Not that Candace Sebro is, you know, isn't a good representative, but we had Comrade Lee listed here to be able to do that. Yes. So congratulations to San Fernando TML for yet another year. And I really, really want to encourage the teachers in particular to have a discussion with Mr. Dutton. Oftentimes, he would be able to break it down in simple terms what techniques that showed up in the first, second, and third place that perhaps other schools are not employing in their artwork. So if you want to just... don't jumpy him, please. But you can tap into his skill, his knowledge, his resource, and have a chat with him today before you leave. Teachers from the other schools, yes? All right, so we move on now to the schools that were the quarterfinalists, certificates and vouchers for Debe Hindu Primary School. And I'd like to ask Comrade Rauti Sinanan, our accountant, to distribute these prizes. So we have from Debe Hindu. Is Debe Hindu here? All right. So can I ask members of Debe Hindu, Matthew Sugrim, Shalina Samsudeen, sorry, and Ariane Ramdani, or just one. Yes, okay, so just one student is here. So come forward, please. Again, can we congratulate the school quarterfinalists in the quiz competition? Look forward. Rancho Camado Primary School. Do we have a representative here from Rancho Camado? All right. We'd like to acknowledge them nonetheless. Rancho Camado was a fighting school in the quarterfinalists, but it didn't make it to the semifinal round. Mount Pleasant Government Primary School, another formidable bunch of students. Do we have a, I know we have a representative from Mount Pleasant Government Primary. Can you come up, please? There's only one student. All of them are here? Okay, can I ask of the three students? So we have Aliyah Islam, Aliyah Ali, and Shamaya, is that Kashmir? I did well, thank you. Shamaya Kashmir. And can we congratulate them, please? These, of course, are students who battled out in the quarterfinals, but were unsuccessful, perhaps by a few points, just edging out, you know, by a few points. So they didn't get through to the semifinal round. Up next, Barry Paul Vidic, if you're here, can you come forward? Priya Indarman? No, they're not here. Okay. So can we acknowledge Barry Paul Vidic Primary? And thank all of our quarterfinalists who, though were successful into getting into the quarterfinal round, were not successful in making it into the semifinal round. Thank you very much, Geeta Sinanan, our accountant. I would like to acknowledge the various schools that participated. As you mentioned, it was 31, and we have certificates for all schools. By show of one representative from the schools that are here, I'll call out the school, and if your name is mentioned, please send forward one representative to collect certificates on behalf of your school. Going in alphabetical order, Avocat Vidic Primary School. Yes, I'd like to, Jennifer Charles, sorry. I'd like to ask Jennifer Charles, our Assistant General Secretary. So she'd be on the floor. Okay. So just one representative from each school. Avocat Vidic is, okay, Barak Paul Vidic is not here. Cedrus Anglican Primary, not here. But again, I'm calling it out so that we get an idea of the vast numbers from both St. Patrick and Victoria that participated. Clark Road Hindu was not here. Debe Hindu, Faizabad, Debe Hindu, there you are, sorry, one student. Can we congratulate Debe Hindu? This is the certificates of all of the students that participated, yes? So Miss, you have the task of hunting down these students and distributing it to them. We also had participating this year, Gasparilla Government Primary, who's here. So can we put our hands together for Gasparilla Government Primary School? Can we show them some love, please? And our CRGS participating words of appreciation and congratulations on behalf of the OWTU. We have Granville RC Primary. We have Mount Pleasant Government Primary, the additional certificates for your school. Can a representative come forward, please, to collect them? One of the things that I've heard is that second to death, public speaking or being in front of a crowd is one of those things that people fear most, right? Just physically coming to the front frightens some people. So congratulations to all of those who are brave enough just to jump out of their seats and come collect their prizes. That in and of itself is a degree of bravery. Pinal Quinam Government Primary School, though not here, we acknowledge you. Pepper Village Government Primary, not here, but thank you very much for participating this year. Pipawa Presbyterian Primary School, our representative is coming forward to collect her certificates on behalf of her school. We are very aware that several schools are engaged in graduation and other activities, and therefore it makes it a little difficult for some to come. But those who are here, thank you very much for tuning up. We have Pointe-à-Pitre Government Primary School. We don't have a representative, but thank you. Princess Town Methodist Primary School, Rancho Camado Government Primary, Siparia Hindu. Anyone from Siparia Hindu Primary School? Santa Flora Government Primary School, Southern. There he comes. Which school is this? Santa Flora Government Primary School. Are you from Santa Flora, Comrade Marchon? You said that with some gusto there. Santa Flora. Okay. Another Talawa member from our school systems. I move on now to South Oropouche Government Primary. No, not here, but thank you for participating this year. St. Christopher Anglican Primary. Tulsa Trace Hindu Primary School, thank you very much for your involvement, your enthusiasm, and your honesty, Shrima. I asked Shrima, you okay?
No, miss.
You nervous?
Yes, miss.
Thank you very much for your honesty and your bravery. San Fernando Azja Primary, and you can't tell me we don't have a representative here from San Fernando Azja Primary. Come forward and collect your certificates. Anushka with a K and a H and a A and a N. I got that. We had to get the correct spelling. She insisted. That's too cute. San Fernando Girls Anglican Primary School. No, we can keep clapping though, keep clapping. San Fernando Girls Government Primary School. San Fernando TML Primary School. I know Sir from TML is not going to be happy when I say this, but I invite a school in next year because we celebrate our 8th anniversary next year. And we want to see a school really give TML a run for their money. Because this is the 5th year San Fernando TML is residing permanently, it seems, at this position in the first place. But we want to open up the challenge here to any school, and we have some good schools, huh? We have a lot of, so pointing to Sir from Abercart Vedic. We have a lot of good schools. All of the schools in this space were excellent in their performance at the quarterfinals. We saw it, and we want to see a school make sure that TML, Caitlin is like, no miss, that TML San Fernando gets a run for their money next year. Same, we move on with our list of participants. St. John's Anglican Primary School. We can keep clapping. St. Peter's Private Primary School. Vance River RC Primary School. Voss Government Primary School. I know we're getting tired, but we're winding down. We can also give them a good clap for their involvement. And Miss, whoever designed your new logo that we can see from the highway, wow. I love it. On the roof of the building, Voss Government, you can see it from the highway. I was just totally thrown by that. Very, very creative. Move on to the last participating school, the 31st, if you will, but by no means the least, Woodland Hindu Primary School. We will endeavor, of course, to get the certificate. Thank you very much, Comrade Jennifer Charles. We would endeavor, of course, to get the certificates to the schools who are not able to make it today, so that the teachers can distribute it to the respective students. All right, so we're moving on to the quiz finalists. And I will like to invite Comrade Marchand again. Comrade Gregory Marchand, Vice President. So these are the two semifinal winners, yes. Which will be Tusa Trace Hindu School. So can I ask for a representative from Tusa Trace Hindu School? Yes? And I believe there's room enough for the other two members here. She's like, Miss, I could go, Miss. Yes, you can go. Karen and the lot. Miss, can you join them as well? She's like, oh, Lord. Okay. Just hold 1 second. Hold. Come to the side. They spelled your name wrong? So any incorrect spelling of names can be fixed straight away? Is that correct? Yes. So immediately once we're over, we can get that correction made. Can I just get a group shot, please, with the OWTU camera of Comrade Marchand and the four? Stacey, could you come forward, please, and just capture that? Could you go to the center? Yeah. Comrade Marchand, look forward and go. Yeah. This was their first, Miss, is that correct? Their first time entering, and they made it all the way to the semifinal round. And our other semifinalists, though not finalists by a we have Avocat Vedict. Don't look so slum. It's okay. There is a next year. But you are champions today. So come forward, all three members of Avocat Vedict, sir included. And Comrade Gregory Marchand will give you your certificates and prizes. Could you just go more center? And there you go. Let us know when you're ready, please, photographers, or when you're finished. Great. Thank you very much, Avocat Vedict. And we move now into second place. And thank you very much, Comrade Marchand. I'd like to invite Comrade Sati Gajada Innes to distribute these certificates. We have in second place, of course, as we saw today, we have San Fernando Asja. So all of the students here, San Fernando Asja, come forward. And they're like opening up their envelopes quickly, like Christmas morning. I love it. And here we are. Make sure to look forward when you're taking the shots. Oh, yes. Where's Miss? Miss?
Oh.
San Fernando Azja. The students don't do it on their own. They need the encouragement and the push and sometimes a little buff up, right? So teachers make it happen. You know, the same was it, Munan moves mountains. Teachers and parents really move mountains, huh? Great. Oh, Comrade Sati, you can stay. And the first place, San Fernando TML. So can we congratulate San Fernando TML, all three of the students who participated in the quiz, the OWTU's 38th annual Labor Day quiz and poster painting competition. Our winners this year are San Fernando TML. So, Comrade Sati Gajida Innes, one by one. That's young Caitlin. Young Karina. And Ravita. Teacher, where is our teacher? Miss, you're getting accustomed to it. She just put down the bag and charged forward. I like that spirit. Well done. No longer, no, you gonna, sir, you gonna. And yes. What just happened? Oh. Sure. So this is first place, and I believe you also give them the winning school quiz, is that correct? All right, so the large trophy you're seeing in front is the school trophy that goes into their showcase at San Fernando TML Primary, and the other trophies are individual trophies. It goes home with Caitlin, Karina, and Ravita. So, yes, we'd like to invite our General Secretary, Comrade Lee, to give the overall winning school because of the work that you did in both quiz and poster painting, the points that you earned from preliminaries to now, and the time that you put in to ensure that your students, yet again, rose to the top of this year's OWTU quiz and poster painting competition. Can we congratulate these young students and ask sir, who I think is now the principal? Are you not? Oh, wow. Congratulations. Sir is now the principal who used to be the teacher coaching these students year in, year out. And now Miss has taken on that baton. So can both of you all join us? Bring your trophies. That's fine. This is your moment to show off. No one's gonna, fault you for that. Oops, watch out. Sorry, come to the side. So the principal of San Fernando TML is receiving the overall challenge trophy, so the overall winning school of both competitions. And in our lineup, we have our General Secretary, Richard Lee, the principal, our three students. Can we clap, please? Can we clap for them? And our teacher slash coach. Let me know when you're ready to move on. It'll be to you, camera, and we're good. Thank you very much, San Fernando TML. And ladies and gentlemen, this is it. We've come to the end of the 38th annual OWTU poster and quiz competition, primary school competition, which involves schools from St. Patrick and Victoria. And I, from North Trinidad, really hope that perhaps for the 80th anniversary of the OWTU, it becomes a national quiz competition. So San Fernando TML may be going up against some other schools, Avocat Vidic, right? And some other schools in other counties and districts. I have a very simple task of sharing my appreciation and thanks as an individual member of the Education and Research Department, but also as a member of the Oilfield Workers Trade Union and on behalf of the executive. There are a few persons I'd like to point out. I would like to first acknowledge the parents and the teachers who shape these minds and take time, because there's a lot of time and a lot of patience to engage young people. But you do it, and you do it with love. So thank you very much to teachers and parents. To our students who never gave up, you saw the material that came to your school, you could have said, Miss Na, that is real reading, Miss Na, I'm not able. But you didn't give up. You saw the material, you challenged yourself, and you went forth. So you pressed forward, and you made it this far. So thank you very much to all of the students, brave as you are, for having taken your time to learn the material and to shine here today at our quiz and poster painting prize giving. So can we congratulate the students? We have a lot of persons working in the back, persons in the front, persons on, flanked on either side. So members of staff of the OWTU, the Education Research Department, our library, a subset of the ERD, our Labor Relations Department, our secretariat, even persons who pitched in from our school, our Butler Rienzi Labor College in the quarterfinals. Thank you very much. Staff really are the backbone of organizations, and there's no way that we can slide staff because they make things happen. So thank you very much, staff of the OWTU, for your work in ensuring that this happened today. Can we congratulate them? And the folks at the head table are here for a reason. Our accountant, Rauti Sinanan, who never hesitates to give out the monies needed to do these kinds of activities. It takes money, not just, you know, time and effort and sweat, but it takes money. And Rauti Sinanan ensures that we have it in a timely manner. Thank you very much. Our executive officers, Sati Gajada Innes, Jennifer Charles, Gregory Marchan, and of course, our General Secretary, Richard Lee. Of course, we'd like to acknowledge Comrade Glenn Dutton for his work, and thank you very much to the Chief Education and Research Officer, who, though not present, is also always with us going through this process. The media workers who are here, 24 frames, you responded in less than 24 seconds to say yes, you would record when Win TV pulled out. So thank you very much to 24 frames to responding to recording the event to ensure that in the next month or so we'll be able to broadcast this on television. And our audio, Mr. Mohammed, year in, year out, thank you very much, sir, for your contribution. If I have forgotten anyone, forgive me, but I would like to extend my thanks on behalf of the Oilfield Workers Trade Union. And my small message to our students really is to press on. There are things that need to be challenged. There are things that need to be changed in this life. And as a leader of today, you have that power to begin to make that change. Never think that your age or your class or your skin color or your status inhibits you from doing anything. You can do anything you put your mind to. So I challenge you to make this piece of rock that we love and we call home, Trinidad and Tobago, a better Trinidad and Tobago in every decision that we make. So children, students, press on. Thank you very much for having participated, and thank you. I invite you all to partake in refreshments. Take a...
Just tell us your name and your portfolio.
My name is Shahid Alaham, and I'm the acting principal of the San Fernando TML Primary School.
So this is
fifth year in a row.
Yeah, what is responsible for this continued success? That you
well, commitment and dedication. You, we are given the literature from OWTU, and we go through it, and we make these children see a sense of meaning in the story. Mm-hmm. We do it in a sequential manner, and they learn the literature, and then we do testing on it.
How long you
took
to prepare for this?
This literature, they started preparing after they wrote SE on the 5th of May.
Training for it?
No, well, you find after SE your children are not geared towards too much academics, so we have to coax them a little bit and show them the importance and encourage them to come, that it will be beneficial to them and history in general.
Mm-hmm. So other schools, you had 31 people coming up against you.
That is like asking me to sell my franchise.
Like that.
No, it's just to take the literature and work with the students. You have to get students who are willing to commit their time and their school time and commit themselves, dedicate themselves, you know, towards it. Because this is the period children who write SEA like to relax, and academic work is not on their agenda. So you have to impress upon them the meaning of what they are doing.
With a track record like that, victory after victory, do you find that you have parents who are willing to send the children to work with you?
Of course, when we tell the parents, you know, our track record and you know, the challenges that we would face, they encourage them. They work together with us. We have a fairly active PTA who supports the teachers and the students in whatever we are doing.
It was really thrilling and exciting. I felt really, really happy that we were able to bring glory to our school once again. And I have to thank God for answering my prayers and making us successful. I have to thank my principal and my teachers for always taking the time to go through the literature with us and making sure that we know everything. And my parents, all of our parents, because they were willing to let us do this and they supported us always. So,
well, I am Sayan Maharaj and I am the first place winner of the poster competition for the OWCU. Before I knew about this competition, I was already informed of the climate change situation, and I was passionate about it, so I already started working on something at home. So when this competition was informed to me, I immediately reacted by entering. So I was really able to put all my ideas into this poster and put all my passions into it, and I knew I could do really great things with it. Thank you.
Champion, champion, champion.
No.
Champion, 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 champion. Champion, 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 champion. Champion.
Okay.
Just tell me, in three words, say it out loud, like I encourage you to do on this stage. Say it out loud. And you started by saying this experience was
a very difficult one to learn, especially since I had so much papers. In the end, it was fun.
In the end, it was?
Fun.
It was fun. Nice. Leah, do you have anything to say? You want to add anything? All right. When you finish, yeah? I just have the finish.
Okay.
Well, this experience was unique and something I've never done before, and it was very enjoyable, and it changed my perspective of the OWTU.
And who you are? What school?
Avocad Vidic.
Your name?
Leah. Leah Philip.
I spoke already, but we could speak again. So on behalf of the students, teachers and staff of the Avocad Vidic School, I would like to take this opportunity to thank the OWTU in this wonderful experience and initiative for the 2016 poster and quiz competition.
Oh yeah!
One more time. Dun, 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 dun. Yeah.
Education, education, this is the foundation. Our rising population needs sound education to be recognized anywhere you go. You gotta have your certificate to show to enjoy any kind of happiness. Knowledge is the key to success. Children go to school and learn well. Otherwise, later on in life, you could get rebel. Without an education in your head, your whole life will be pure misery. You better run dead. For there is simply no room in this whole wide world for an uneducated little boy or girl. Don't allow idle companions to lead you astray. To earn tomorrow, you got to learn today. Hit it. For employment, yes, employment, you must be intelligent. It's essential, very essential, to have your credential. Remember, if you're blockheaded like a mule, no one will employ a fool. You will be the last one to be hired and the very first one to be fired. Children go to school and learn well. Otherwise, later on in life, you're gonna catch real hell. Without an education in your head, your whole life will be pure misery. You better off dead, dead, dead. Dead. For there is simply no room in this whole wide world for an uneducated little boy or girl. Don't follow idle companions or we will get burned. To earn, you gotta learn. You gotta learn. Illiteracy, illiteracy is man's greatest enemy. So it's your duty, yes, your duty, stamp it out completely. Ignorance always impede progress. Education saves you much distress. Learn, 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 learn as much as you can. This nation's future is in your hand. Children go to school and learn well. Otherwise, later on in life, you're gonna catch real hell. Without an education in your head, your whole life will be pure misery. You're better off dead, I mean dead, dead. For there is simply no room in this whole wide world for an uneducated little boy or girl. Don't allow idle companions to lead you astray. To earn tomorrow, you got to learn today. is a treasure, yes, a treasure beyond any measure. So secure it, just secure it, don't ever ignore it. I said to find life's battles, come what may. Education will light up your way. Without it, you'll never, never, never get through. Success or failure now is up to you. Children go to school and learn well. Otherwise, later on in life, you're gonna catch real hell. Without